for me, there's no doubt that the magnet system is the one part that really matters the most in a speaker driver. I think also it's the part where we have put in most effort. I think we have refined the magnetic motor system for speaker drivers to a very, very high degree. But even that grain structure can be perfected by putting it into a cryogenic treatment, and the result is something that resembles a monocrystal. Working in high end, you find out that everything sounds like what it's created from. If you knock on a piece of glass or a membrane or whatever, you will get a sonic signature. And that sonic signature is in everything. This is where the cryogenic treatment comes in. When you subject the metals or the drivers or part of the drivers in a 72-hour process, we put it in liquid nitrogen, and it takes about 24 hours to cool down, and then we hold it for 24 hours, and then it takes about 24 hours to get back up to room temperature. And again, what we see and what we measure is that after a 72-hour cryogenic treatment, we end up with a conductor that is about 6 to 8% better than it was before we put it in the cryogenic chamber. Because when you subject metals to a very, very low temperature, they keep contracting, and creating a more and more perfect crystalline structure, leaving no rooms for dislocation, leaving no rooms for alloying elements that distorts this metal frame. That means impurities, other metals are pushed out of the grain structure, and the metal becomes more and more pure. And that leaves it in the end with a better and better conductivity. As a good example, I had a kitchen knife, which was a really lousy knife, and I put it in the cryogenic and I hardened it and came back, and the minute I put it on the grinding stone to sharpen it, I could feel it was very different. So of course it's very interesting that you can push performance to an even higher degree with doing something mechanical to it. It fixes nothing, yet it changes everything. So if you have something that is flawed, it doesn't add quality to it. But if something is really good, it makes the qualities come out. And I think that cryogenic treatment, now we have explored it extensively on the drivers, on the speakers, and of course there's it's a process that we are still looking very much into. Where can that be employed? Lars and I was looking at each other and saying, are there steps we can go further? Are there ways we can better performance? Are there ways we can get materials to conduct better? And what we have seen is that if you take silver and you treat it with cryogenic, the sound becomes very warm and very organic, yet very transparent. But I don't think that silver can stand alone without the treatment. I think that you need to do the cryogenic treatment to get the maximum results. So for us, I see that these two technologies go hand in hand. They go hand in hand in speakers. They go hand in hand maybe in other areas for the future. But for now, I think that we are at a level where, compared to other magnet systems that has iron in, we have reduced 90% of the sonic signature from the magnet system, and I think that's a huge step, that's a huge leap forward in performance.